Okay, this is Bob Swanson, ICC Astronomy Instructor. We're going to talk about the Module 6 lab activity. Of course, if you've gone into the modules on Canvas and you've gone to the Module 6 lab activity, you're going to see the link to the student guide. You're going to see a link to the activity itself as well as the link to the lab quiz. So let's talk about the link to the lab simulation. When you click on that, it's going to bring you up to the Planetary Orbits Lab. And again, as I tend to stress, you know, go through the content as well, the main content as well as the simulator. The simulator is going to help you get through the student guide, but it's very important that you go through the background material first. That's going to help you answer the first page or so of the student guide. That's just background material. So the first page of background is about Kepler's laws. And I know this is a bit of a review. It's been several chapters since you learned about Kepler's laws. In fact, I think you learned about Kepler back in chapter 4 about the origins of modern astronomy. But Kepler, you can't understate how crucial he was to the development of astronomy. He took a lot of Brahe's observations and put math to them, figured out the math behind what Brahe was observing. And he realized a couple of very big things. First of all, that the heavenly objects, the planets, don't move in circular orbits. In fact, he realized they move in elliptical orbits. He also realized that they don't move at uniform speeds. They change their speed. Those were crucial. Without Kepler and those insights, we wouldn't really understand how the planets orbit stars, etc., etc. So this whole background page deals with the first law, which is the law of ellipses. He realized that planets move not in circles but in ellipses, and you can actually describe the how elliptical an orbit is by a couple of different values. The value of the semi-major axis, which is the distance from the center of the orbit to the edge, and you can change that. Notice as I slide this thing, the A value, the semi-major axis, changes, and then your C value, which is the distance from the center to one of the foci. There's two foci in every ellipse, and as I make this less elliptical, you get a C value that goes down to zero. And then when you divide your C by your A, you get what's called the eccentricity. An ellipse has an eccentricity of zero, it's a circle. It's not very eccentric. The more eccentric it is, the more out of round it gets. The second law has to do with how the planet moves during its orbit. Because it is sometimes closer to the star and sometimes farther away, that changes its speed. And then finally, the third law has to do with the orbital period, essentially the length of the year, and how far away the planet is from its star. And so there's a beautiful relationship. P squared is equal to A cubed. P, which is in years, and A, when it's in AUs, astronomical units. So for example, the Earth. How far away is the Earth? It's 1 AU away. What's 1 cubed? It's 1. What's the square root of 1? 1. Turns out that the orbital period of the Earth is 1 year, because it is only 1 AU away from its star. So that's that background page. Also check out the Newton and planetary motion page, because those Kepler set the stage. Kepler didn't know why planets moved around a star. He just knew that they did, and he came up with a mathematical relationship to describe that motion. It wasn't until Newton rolled around, Newton gave reason for why a planet orbits around a star. Newton realized in his first law that an object in motion, such as a planet, should go off in a straight line into space, and yet we know that the planets do not. They orbit around stars. And the reason they do is because of Newton's law of universal gravitation, which says that the sun essentially exerts a pull on the planets, which causes them to constantly move in these elliptical orbits. So that's all the background information. This will then set you up to do the planetary orbit simulator. And actually, I'll refresh this and show you what it looks like when you first open it up. And it's actually a pretty easy, straightforward simulation. In the first part, when you're doing the simulation, you can change your semi-major axis, you can change the eccentricity. I also recommend that you click on the Show Empty Focus and show the radial lines, because you're going to be asked to move your planet around to different locations and essentially write down what the R1 and R2 values are. And you're going to come up with a little relationship. And you can actually start your animation. You can make it animate as well and watch it go around. That's all pretty straightforward. But you'll notice that the planet does not move at a steady speed the entire time. It tends to slow down on the right side, speed up on the left side. And that is actually has a lot to do with Kepler's second law. So when you are done with the first part of the planetary orbit simulator, it'll ask you to click on the Kepler's second law tab. When you do that, I think it recommends that you change your sweep size to 1/12. So you just adjust this, and then you start sweeping. And every time you hit start sweeping, it's going to sweep out. And you'll do this and answer some questions about that. And you can change the eccentricity, you can change your semi-major axis. That's all pretty straightforward. All right, I'm going to erase my sweeps. I'm going to move on to the next tab, Kepler's third law. And what you're going to find with Kepler's third law is this relates, remember, the orbital period with the distance from the star. And this is pretty straightforward. And so what you can do is play around with the different planets. You can change your semi-major axis and your eccentricity and see how that affects your period and your semi-major axis. So for example, going back to the Earth. Remember, the Earth is 1 AU away from the Sun, and its period is 1 year. And it works out mathematically. And again, you can just check it out for some of the other planets. You can fill out a little table. You know, for Jupiter, you hit OK. It shows that Jupiter is 5 AUs away from the Sun. Its eccentricity is 0.048, and you can see how its distance from the Sun affects its period, and you can read it off. Okay? So its period is about 11.9 years. That mathematically works out. When you cube 5.2, that is equal to 11.9 squared. And then finally, the last thing is about Newtonian features. I'm going to reset this, actually, and go back to a more simple orbit. Now, if I hit start animation, we see my planet goes around, seems to slow down on this side, speed up when it's close to the Sun. And what you can do is you can, first of all, click on the acceleration vector. So the planet always accelerates toward the Sun. The Sun is pulling on that planet. It's exerting a force, and the acceleration is in the direction of the force. So you can see that the acceleration vector is always pointed toward the Sun. Now you can click on the velocity vector. This is essentially the speed and direction of the planet at any particular moment. And so you can pause it if you want, and you can see that, well, gosh, when it's close to the Sun, you can see that the length of the vector is pretty darn long. And notice that the length of the vector changes. And so there's a little diagram that you're supposed to fill out to show how the velocity vector changes as a planet orbits the Sun. And that's pretty much it. So make use of these four tabs, make use of the different controls and the different settings, and you should be able to move through this pretty quickly and then answer the questions to the lab quiz. But again, spend time with some of these background pages, because these are going to actually answer a lot of the questions in your lab quiz. All right, good luck.